What's going on, guys? It's your boy. Welcome back to another Modern Monday here on Channel Fireball. Coming at you with the dankest of memes today. This deck looks ridiculous. I saw this deck. It was played in a Modern Challenge. I believe it went 5-1, which is good enough for us. So we have the standard all-star Voldaren Pariah to Madness out. We also have Grave Scrabblers to Madness out. Ridiculous little Future Sight Gravedigger. And we have this card that you probably just want to discard and cast for its despair cost because we have no serviceable green mana in the deck. So basically, until the end of turn, your creatures get menace and they make them discard cards whenever they deal damage. Four Big Game Hunters taking down things like Tarmogoyfs. Two Lingering Souls also discarding because we have no white sources either. Liliana's makes things like Squee pretty easy to discard. A Ruthless Sniper. Which is just ridiculous, but can kill things pretty efficiently. So we have four of those dudes, one dark blast, one fatal push, four crypt breakers. And actually this dark blast is reasonable because it lets us get back things like Squee. It lets us cast Lingering Souls. So there's quite a few cards like you don't mind having in the graveyard. And ideally you're going to be casting a crypt breaker, making zombies with Zombie Infestation and then drawing cards. So we'll see. This is not a zombie. Call of the Blood makes vampires and not zombies. But this deck looks super interesting and grindy, and looking forward to seeing how it does. So without further ado, let's check it out. What's going on, guys? Welcome back to round one with Mardu Madness. I just want to mention that Mardu Madness is actually kind of a misnomer for this deck. We don't really have any white cards that we're casting, and it's very rare that we're casting Squee. We do have Blood Moon in the sideboard, though, so it is kind of a red-black deck. But, you know, we're gonna just ignore that because Mardu Madness just rolls off the tongue a little better. I don't like this hand because we have no discard outlets, and we have five cards that want to be discarded. So this is more reasonable, even though we don't have a second land, but I think we're just going to keep it anyway, so seems good. Land on top. Ooh, put it on top. So now we can actually just play that into Ruthless Sniper. Then we can Zombie Infestation. Oh my god, our opponent's going to be like, wow, Ruthless Sniper on turn one. Well, that's a thing. So you can't spell Pierce It. You can't spell Snare It. You can Force Spike. Is that even legal in this format? I don't know. Hard to say. Magic's... Oh, I know what's happening, and I don't know if this is good for us. It seems like it's decent with Zombie Infestation, right? Of course, Ruthless Sniper is kind of... That's just a sad dude. Alright, so... We're not getting a red source here. There ain't no reason for that. We're just going to Zombie Infestation. Attack for one. Do we just discard, like, fire cards? And make two twos? Oh my god, this is so many Blood Moons. Do you know how many guys we're going to make? I mean, not Blood Moons, Howling Mines. You know what I'm saying. Let's get rid of... Probably... I guess we can play Scrabbler next turn. So Fatal Push and probably Swamp is fine. Not going to use this ability. Nope. I guess we could have made... another zombie, but now we have a Crypt Breaker. So, play Crypt Breaker. Attack for 1, 2, 3. And now we can go discard Pariah, Scrabbler, get back Pariah. Probably discard both lands just to have enough, a bunch of pressure on the board. Seems good. I mean, I don't. Once they start taking their turns, though, then we're kind of. Did they miss a land drop? They've drawn like a million lands and they missed a land drop? One and a two. I'll choose this zombie and this guy so we don't make any kind of mistakes. This needs to go in the graveyard, right? Yeah, okay, this guy doesn't trigger until he comes into play, so. No. Okay. Yes. How do I pay? Okay, there we go. One, two. This is a thing. This is a confusing thing we're doing here. You can counter this? You counter in Scrabbly? This is a zombie. We can tap this guy with Curb Breaker. And draw another card? Oof. This deck is saucy. I don't know if you guys can hear that. It's thundering outside. Remand old Scrabbly. Sure. Nope. Nope. I'm just going to make another zombie here with these other lands. I don't want to do this ever. Nope. Nope. And now we can actually draw a card, which is nice. Zombo. Zombo. One, two, three. We could get rid of this guy and make another zombie right now. Doesn't really increase our clock, though. So we're not going to do that. This is interesting, because even if they hit another land, they still don't have time mana? What does that even mean? 1, 2, 3, 4, 7... Just going to attack with everybody here, I think. So this guy for 2 mana makes it, guys. We can go 1, 2... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, activate, discard. So this is going to be 4 mana. Make a zombie, make a zombie. We're like one card shy, right? So we're going to tap this and... Oh, we're making another zombie, though. Yeah, so we're going to actually keep this guy back because it's just better for us. Then we can get Pariah. Swampums. So we go activate Crypt Breaker, discard Scrabbler, cast. So then we have Scrabbler and Crypt Breaker, the Crypt Breaker zombie. So that's 2 zombies. We'll discard 2 lands to make a 3rd zombie. Tap the 3 to draw a card. And then we'll discard Liliana and whatever we draw for another zombie, which should be a lot of zombies. And it will be a lot of zombies, so... Exhaustion would be pretty good. I think... Yep, that's what we were kind of afraid of, I guess. Well, it's just better to make this guy, so... yeah, this might have been... We might not have maximized our zombie damage. Oh, I also have this, too. I forgot about that, actually. Nope. Oh, my God. We're gonna have, like, everything... We're gonna be 1 point shy, aren't we? Paying costs... Giga Drouse. All right. Well, there's a lot of things happening, so I'm going to go no. No. Having to say no every time against the... Do we even actually cast the Liana? You deal them six? We're not going to actually play these cards anytime soon, so whatever. Just anything. Now we get to draw three anyway. Nope. No to everything. Actually, I could probably auto-yield to the Ruthless Snipers and just say no, right? Okay, that's pretty good. All right, put you to three. And now you have to draw like land and time warp. I'm sure you have time warps in hand. Otherwise, if you don't have lands in hand, you have time warps. So we just have to hope you... Yep, there's land. Followed by an instant time warp. Yep. And this is where the fun starts. The Time Warp deck is probably one of my favorite decks, so I can't be that upset that it's winning. I think I was probably one of the first players to actually show it off in a video. Here comes old Walk the Aeons. I like Part a little bit better here just because, for us, because it exiles itself and it gets rid of one of their win conditions, maybe? But they are drawing three cards a turn, so over the course of two turns, they draw six cards and only have to find one time warp in them. Yep. So, like, for example, this turn here, they drew three, and then their second turn, they're going to draw three. So that's five cards. That have to be non-time warps. It's a lot of things. A lot of things are happening here. Sure. I don't... Like, there's no reason to scoop, though, which is the unfortunate part. Keep F6ing, even though there is going to come a point where they don't have any turns left. Maybe there's going to come a point. They could just actually... Part the water veil here, yep. But we can actually make blockers, which is pretty sweet. Well, I guess we can make a blocker. But nevertheless. I feel like we almost take six here. Like, taking six is actually fine. Nine cards. Unbelievable. That's too many cards. Can you have less than nine? Well, certainly. I'll go down to eight right now as I walk the A. That should be game. Well, they didn't buy it back, though. Which means they're guaranteed to have another time walk in their hand. Quote unquote time walk. Yep, there it is. There it is. Yeah, go to seven here. I feel like we could have definitely won this game, which is a weird feeling. I'm not backing it up with any kind of statistics or facts or information. I'm just kind of assuming that we could have. This is where they have one Giga Drouse in hand. They tap down our one blocker. And then we die. Choose you two. I don't have any mana. Well, I gotta pay one for this ability. I guess because it would be absolutely busted if you didn't, maybe, but they're so ready. They're so ready for this. Even if they're not, they already parted the water veil, right? So it doesn't matter. We're just going to scoop here. Yeah, sure. So everything went according to plan for them. All right. So mono blue deck. Blood Moon doesn't seem great. Collective Brutality does, however. Ruthless Sniper, probably not ideal. Thought Seizes, probably ideal. Fatal Push and Dark Blast, also not great. Everything else? Oh, Big Game Hunters can probably come out for one Lingering Souls, I guess. Nihil Spellbomb, Grafdigger's Cage. Can't cast spells from graveyards or libraries. I mean, Big Game Hunter, like, actually does nothing in this matchup, which is pretty sad. I think Nihil Spellbomb might just be better. But, I mean, like, that's presuming they have, that's from the Candy Bar commercial. Presuming they have Snapcaster Mage in some form, which I imagine they do. All right, well, yeah, this hand seems good. Turn one, Thoughtseize into turn two, Zombie Infestation, discarding Lingering Souls and Squee. Seems okay. Next turn, get Squee back. All right, well. Time Warp, Serum Visions, Part, Giga Drowse, Exhaustion. One land. Let's take this Serum Visions here. That seems good. Wow, Giga Drowse, my one land. Okay, so you played this island and the Giga Drowse. That's just rude, I think, but... Oh, got there anyway. So that's pretty sweet, actually. Discarding Squee every turn to make a Zombo is pretty reasonable. Oh, they hit a land. Look at that. Look at this guy. Pretty sure it's just Zombie Infestation here, right? Could also make a zombie here, but I think we actually just go... Yeah, we're just going to attack for one. We're not going to make two dudes this turn. Because I want to keep Collective Brutality in hand. Oh, missed the land drop. Just as we planned. Always yes, and always yield. Give me another Squee. That's not a Squee at all. So one thing we can do is discard Squee and, like, Liliana. Make a zombie, draw a card. Try to hit a land. Is that what we want to do? Do we just want to attack for like a million? Yeah, let's just Thoughtseize you and attack for a million, I guess. Dictate of Kruphix. I think that's your card, right? So you got 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We're just trying to slow you down to kill you with these zomberinos. Actually, is 3 damage worth it? Oh, maybe it's not. Maybe we just draw a card here and then we can actually make another zombie? Yeah, that seems okay. Okay, Call of the Blue Line seems fine. If we hit a land, we could have Lingering Souls, which would have been nice. Oof, here comes the Exhaustion. But then they have to hit another land. Dictate slows them down pretty reasonably. If we hit a land, we can also... Ooh, they did not exhaustion. I guess we don't have enough pressure. We're not scary enough for them. Multiple squeeze is pretty good for us. Not having another creature is kind of sad, though. What if we go... Discard these two. Cast Grave Scrabbler. Get Squee back. Make a Zombo. Discard. Call and Squee. Draw card with these three new guys. Lingering Souls. And then we'll just attack for five here. And now I feel like you're at a point where you kind of have to exhaustion because... I'll probably just kill you if you don't. So we know all five cards in your hand. That's pretty good. Your cards drawn were like Dictate land from your opening hand. Yep, that makes sense. It makes sense, huh? Could discard another Lingering Souls to just play it, but I'd rather just discard the Squee. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I think we actually do discard. No, because we can actually just cast the Collective Brutality to kill them as well, so. Land is good. I do like a land. Well, they didn't hit a land, but now if they get Cryptic Command, they can tap our team down, which is unfortunate. And then if they hit another land, they can Time Warp part, but they don't have any kind of engine right now, which is nice. Oh, this is good. I feel like any turn I'm not getting Squee back is just bad. This is 13, and then we can actually collect a Brutality them. So unless they drew Giga Drowse. Oh, it's the double Squee. Is it a Giga Drowse? This is hilarious. So these two and someone else, right? Oh, all right. That's cool. I'm glad that resolved. All right. Well, that was fun. So 1, 2, 3. And now we're just going to take Cryptic Command, which, oh, we'll just also skip our combat step. Okay, so main phase, it doesn't really matter. Like, we either win in a turn or we don't. So, cast with Escalate, lose two, and opponent reveal hand, cast, target you, discard a land, get rid of Cryptic. All right, Well, we didn't attack, so we might as well... Yeah, we'll just keep these guys up. It doesn't do anything, so it's fine. Well, that's your draw for the turn. So it doesn't actually get you ahead. It just lets you do a thing. And if you hit a land, you can't cast any of the cards in your hand. So you have four cards, you know, Time Warp, Part, and Time Warp, right? It's ridiculous. All right, cool. All right, I think our deck is fine in this configuration. It does feel like we have to get a little lucky, and I feel like we did last game. Just because... well, this hand is actually reasonable. Call of the Bloodline is not Zombie Infestation, but... Thoughtseize and Grave Scrabbler. Actually, I mean, it's almost the same. I mean, it's a little more mana intensive. It costs 2 mana, whereas Zombie Infestation costs 0. But if we discard a card on our turn, a card on their turn, we're still getting 2 power for 2 mana. Or for 2 cards, rather. Which is not terrible. So, I feel like we just spell bomb here. Well, okay, so I don't know. That was the wrong land to play. I thought this was actually Blackleaf Cliffs over here, but the life, I don't think the life's going to matter. But it probably will, because we had no reason to play this untapped. Because it's actually 3 hits from Part the Water Veil instead of 2, which is pretty bad. Or instead of 4, rather. So, just thinking. So what we're going to do next time, we're going to play Call the Bloodline. They're going to go second land, we call the Bloodline. They're going to go third land, Exhaustion. Fourth land, they'll have Cryptic Command up. I think we actually have to play Thoughtseize here. Doesn't feel great, but... What? Sphinx's Tutelage. We have no answer for that, interestingly enough. Oof, that's interesting. We could also take the Howling Mine. God, it might just be the Howling Mine. Yeah, I'm going to take the Howling Mine. I feel like that's better. We also have another chance to draw another land or so. Yep, seems good. We did not draw. Call the Bloodline. Somebody call the Bloodline! What does that even mean? Wish Grape Scrabbler got any card back, and we get our thought. Next time we can get our Thoughtseize back. We couldn't cast it though. So when you have Sphinx's Tutelage, you've played 2 lands, I presume. So many Grave Scrabblers, man. Okay, so we're just going to pass, and if they want to play Exhaustion, they can, which doesn't really do much because we don't have tap. We nothing. That's... Ooh, look at that guy. Man, now they get to play Tutelage. Yeah, this is going to be rough. But they could put a bunch of Squees in our graveyard. Scrabbler does get back Squee, which is pretty cool. Yep, that's pretty cute. Actually, no. No, that was terrible. What's wrong with me? You only activate this once a turn. Oh my god, that was just the worst. I'm sorry, guys. That is not a thing I'm used to. I had this whole plan. We discard Squee, but then we can only use this once a turn, so we kind of had to do it on our turn. But we didn't really have the mana to do that. All right, so... Discard Squee now, I guess? We just want Squee in the graveyard. Squee, just get in the graveyard, buddy. Cryptbreaker not as good. Now we can discard Scrabbler and cast it. That's really all we want to do. Should be fine. Okay. Yeah, that was a waste of a turn, I feel like. But we cast Scrabbler, get Scrabbler back. So we Scrabble into Scrabble. It puts 3 power on board. And it mills us for a million. However, thankfully, a lot of our cards are very good in the graveyard. However, they are at a point where they can actually just start casting things like Time Warp, so that's cool. And we know they have Cryptic Command and Exhaustion in hand. Yeah, this is probably over. Like, as a black deck, we have just no answers to Sphinx's Tutelage. As a black-red deck, we have no answer to Sphinx's Tutelage. They also hit no more Squeeze, and they hit no more... Okay. All right. Well, not terrible. However, I think they mill us before we actually get to do anything. Yes. Now we will cast this one and get back. Probably, is it Pariah? 6/5 seems pretty good. We can probably just get Grave Scrabbler back for now and then do Pariah later. Would you like to get Squee back? Yeah, you know I would. All right, now we get to draw like infinite cards. It's pretty good. Zombie Infestation. Oh, that's what we're looking for. Just a way to get rid of all these cards. Although I have no doubt they're just going to time warp us to infinity next turn, so. I guess we attack here. Puts us to 20. Which is reasonable. I don't know if you guys can hear that rain. It's super loud right now. Oh, boy. So now they draw four cards? Yeah, we're dead. See, like, you have to beat this deck before it gets quote-unquote online. And there are certain decks in the format, like ours, that just aren't going to be able to outrace this because we can't win by the time they start getting there. And they're also milling us for, like, 8 cards this turn, at the very least. I think we're just dead. We had a good run. Oh, good, and they cast that. The Temporal Master was the first card they drew. How nice. How convenient. Well, that's pretty insane. So now they're going to mill us for another 2, 4, 6, 8. 9, 10. Yeah, so. That's the end, the boost. You got it. They know they have another turn, right? Doesn't matter. Yeah, unless they absolutely whiff here and then just don't take the turn. Yeah, it doesn't even matter though, because these guys are going to tap, so we can't actually put 14 power on board. Yeah, that's game. Because we can't beat them in any reasonable capacity. Either way, pretty sweet match here, despite us being significantly outclassed. It seems. Black and red deck just not going to have a way to deal with enchantments and artifacts. So, I mean, we could have taken the Sphinx's Tutelage, but I mean, they had to naturally hit a Howling Mine or a Dictative Crew fix for it to really be good. And then they did. So, all right, yep, that's the end. All right, we'll see you guys next round.
What's going on, guys? We're going to round 2 with Black-Red Madness. I think we're going to keep this hand. Turn 1, Crypt Breaker, turn 2, Call, and we have Squee and Big Game Hunter for some shenanigans. I'm game. Big game. Hunter. Yeah. This big game hunter humor. It wasn't good. It wasn't great. So, Cliffs into Crypt Breaker, and they're going to be like, did you accidentally load your standard deck? Okay. Well, all right. Well, that was... We really taxed the game here, so we're going to have to start over, I guess. That was tough. We added a mana and then tried to play Crypt Breaker. It's more like Magic Online Breaker, am I right? All right, hold on a second. Oh, well, it was... Look, it did make it into play without us having to click again. What efficiency. What a time to be alive. Alright, so next turn, we can call... We can ring up the old bloodline, or we can just make a zombie and discard Squee, which might be better. Because then turn 3, we can call and make a dude. So. That seems good. Man, Liliana, we can also discard Squee every turn. God, what a deck. What? It has 0. Well, I don't understand. Are they going to do some shenanigans? You can't proliferate because it has no counter. Put a charge counter on target artifact. Oh. Well, that's exciting. Whatever's happening right now is exciting me. Alright. Oh, this adds Man of Color, too. Alright, they had a Yavimaya Coast, which we knew about, and then now it's gone. So I'm going to write Coast here. Old Coast with the most. Sure. Alright, so now we know you have Coast and Core Tapper in hand, and while this is a lot of mana you could potentially generate, it's not terribly scary. Oof, two squeeze. Yeah, we're just going to pass and make a Zombo here. Well, not here, but, you know, later. In the future, guys. I do like having two squeeze and Core Cryptbreaker, and, like, this is an engine. Like, we got an engine going on here. It's just going to take a turn, a few turns to, like, really amass enough dudes. And I don't know what's going on here, so... Yeah, you just put them on the cornucopia, right? Because adding four colored mana is better than adding two colored and two colorless, right? I don't know. I don't know how mana works. What, am I some kind of mana scientist? Get rid of old Squee. And then we're going to go here, and then we're going to say always yield and always yes. Because there's never going to be a turn where I'm like, I don't think I want Squee back right this second. I'm good. Oh, Liliana. So we make them sacrifice, and then you know what happens? Nothing, really. They're just going to sacrifice it anyway. But I think we still have to play Lily here, because we have two. We're not going to make them sacrifice, though, because that's stupid. We're just going to start discarding. And we are going to specifically discard Old Goblin Nabob. What Kismet? Alright, so this guy's gone too, right? They played this guy. Let's see what happens. Let's go to the videotape. Oh, Talaria West. Sure to provide endless shenanigans. Alright, well. Get in there. Yeah, block and then counters on. Okay. I mean, this is reasonable still, just because if we have, like, Kolaghan's Command, you don't want to put all your counters on one thing. They were going to activate their Inventor's Fair, and then they realized they only had two artifacts. I'm a fan of what's going on here with Core Tappers and Astral Cornucopias and Everflowing Chalices that you can play for zero. I mean, this costs 6 mana. And 4 mana. This is 10 mana that you saved right here. 5. Oh, this is terrifying. I only have one card in hand, so... Oh my god. I've never been so scared in my life. Alright, I was once, but... It's going to be a land. It's going to be a big game hunter, is what I meant. Yeah. Guess we're discarding. So they're in top deck mode now, except for the fact that they have Inventor's Fair. But... Oh! Aetherflux Reservoir! Look at all the things that are happening right now. I am impressed. I think we call the Bloodline here. Because it lets us attack with these guys. It also lets us make a thing. It's a better use of our mana. Because next turn we can actually Crypt Breaker and call the Bloodline, which is... We're kind of where we want to be when we have double squeeze. Two squeeze. So they go 1, 2, 3, 4, sack this, get a thing, play it for 2, untap everything, play the thing they got. So, all right, well, not thrilled about it. I'm a little afraid. I'm gonna be honest with you guys. It's not a... This is not your normal deck. Paradox Engine, Astral Cornucopia, and Core Tappers. Here we go. Yep. This is exactly what we predicted. They get an artifact. They play it for 2. It untaps all... Well, both of these. I guess the land's not untapped, which is nice. So they only have 4 to work with. There's that whole 6 removing. Yeah, sure. So you're just going to put charge counters on other things. So what you could do is move a charge counter here. And then... Oh, into the colorless one. Sure. Whatever. Okay. Well, that's... 1, 2, 3, 4. They can actually sack, activate this again... Search for another artifact. But it has to cost 1 mana. And then if it's a 1 mana artifact, they can't really do anything else. So. I think. And if they just put it in their hand, we're just going to lay on it out of their hand. So that's okay. Temple Bell. Alright, I'm just going to get rid of that. Does not seem like an ideal choice, but sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do. Did I? Always yes. I don't understand why you're asking me. I literally just said always yes and it's asking me again. That's mind-blowing me. Always yes. Oh, how about right now? Well, yeah, no, this time too. This time too. So now we can play Crypt Breaker, make a zombie. I will discard this. Wonder what you're discarding. Oh, Temple Bell. Who saw that coming? All right, let's see. I think we're just drawing a card here. I want to hit a land drop, maybe. Is the 2 damage better than a card? No. Can I? Yeah, there we go. 1, 2. All right. Getting some lag here because it's Sunday afternoon. So that's your prime time for Magic playing. All right, they're in top deck mode, but anything they draw is just insane, right? Because they have 6 counters here. Yep, put a counter on the Astral Cornucopia. Huh. Well, whatever it was. They're in top deck mode, which is nice, so they can't go crazy. As far as I know. Well, that's pretty good. What is happening right now? This is great. This is great stuff, guys. Oh my god, that proliferate. One, so right now they can make 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. They have 12 mana right now. They can play an Ulamog, which is terrifying. Academy Ruins is a little scary. They're playing a little sloppy, though. Like, they're activating this after they add the mana to their mana pool. Like, you want to tap this, activate this, put the counter on here, and then tap this, right? Like, not the other way around. All right, so no cards in hand. You can sack Mind Stone to draw one more thing, which I presume you're going to do. Putting Temple Bell on top, sure. Yeah, that's pretty good. Now you just Mind Stone, get the Temple Bell, untap all your land, draw a card, untap all your things. I said untap all your things twice, but I don't care. That's fine. You can untap your things as many times as you want. Yeah, see again, like, add mana, move a charge counter. It's just being wasteful. Bloodstained Mire. Oh, and then they get to untap the Temple Bell. Oh, boy. Planar Portal. What a top deck. What an actual top deck. Alright, so now it's just getting a little frustrating. Like, they had to hit Tezzeret's Gambit into Academy Ruins and Mind Stone to draw the card into Planar Portal. Like, that had to be the sequence. That's insane. Like, their Gambit literally had to give them card to put an artifact on top, way to draw that card. And then Temple Bell literally drew them into Planar Portal, which is the next card on top. What insane. I don't know what's happening, so I'm just going to let it play out, I guess, but... Also, it's like, Planar Portal is like a demonic tutor where you don't get to actually see the card because they're able to search for anything, so there's no burden of proof. Like, they don't have to prove that they got an instant or sorcery, and, what are they getting? Quartet? Like, what... You have infinite mana. Oh, are you just going to Blue Sun Zenithus? How much mana is this? Like a million. It's like a million mana. You could just Blue Sun Zenithus right now, probably. Maybe not right now, I guess. But it's close. So... It's got to be an X spell, right? Mox Opal, that ain't an X spell. This is just like, can you just hurry, just hurry it up. just let's get it on with, let's do this. I just put me out of my misery. You're searching for things like Mox Opals and Astral Cornucopias for zero. Alright, I'm going to assume that's all you need, because right now you're making a million mana. 15 is 28, 30, 40 mana. Alright. Now you're adding 15 more, so it's 55. 56, 57, 58. It's more than enough. Here we go. Sure. All we needed to see. All right. I assume because we're a red deck, we have some artifact removal in this. Oh, no, we don't. Okay. Well, that's awkward. Another, like, deck with no creatures. So Ruthless Sniper and Fatal Push and Dark Blast can all come out. Bring in Spell Bomb. Bring in Thought Seize. Probably bring in Blood Moons, right? That seems good. We can take out the big game hunters. And I have to imagine Collective Company is bigger than the other, better than the other big game hunter. I think this is probably where we want to be, I guess. I don't know. Maybe we can fetch a creature deck and have use for these guys. Alright, I will play first because All right, this hand seems good. But I mean, I thought the last one seemed good too, and then we just got stomped. Yeah, I forgot you don't really need things like Blue Sun Zenith. We're in a post-Walking Ballista world, so. Pretty sure we just attack. We're going to make one zombie next turn, whether we spend two on this or two on this. I think we just get the Zombie Infestation on the board since we're getting both squeezed back anyway. Yep, here we go again. Black Cleave Cliffums. All right. Well. The intensity mounts. Excuse me. So, also they have 13 minutes to our 18, 14 to 18 minutes. Like, they're playing a little slower than us. And, oh, kicking it one time, huh? A bold strategy, Cotton. Two squeeze. Well, let's try again. Let's all yes and yield. And you're going to ask me if I want to do it? No, you didn't. Well, that's a consistent thing. That's a consistent thing, he said. Now we're just going to make two zombies here for three cards. And get rid of the other swamp. And just play Bloodstained Mire because I don't feel like... I'd rather thin our deck is really what I was getting at there. So we make a zombie, discard a card. Yeah, we're making two zombies here. And I don't mind pitching a swamp. Here we go. Something scary. Everything they do is scary. When you're playing on an unknown deck like this, it's always a little scary. This is nice because the cornucopia doesn't get a counter. Because you can't just put counters on random permanents. You add a counter to permanents with counters on them. So that's nice. That's a good... The sad thing is this game they have six cards in hand. Last game they had none. And then they just top decked into Gambit, into Way to Draw a Card, and Academy of Ruins... and Temple Bell into Planar Portal, which is like, well, that's a lot of things happening, so. Perhaps Nihil Spellbomb will be useful one day. Always yes. Why? I don't understand why you ask me. I don't understand. I literally said always yes. Now you're like, are you sure, though? No, I'm pretty sure. So, do we draw a card here, is the question. I think we do. Yeah, of course we do. We got two zombies anyway, so. One, two, three. We're only losing 2 points here. And now we can play that guy. I don't know if that's better. Yeah, they're playing red-green, or blue-green. I don't think they're going to actually have anything, any shenanigans here. I also don't think they're in a position where the Academy of Ruins is going to be worth too much. They're at 11. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We have Lethal on board, so that's cool. Could this be game? Could this be the number of zombies we need to get the job done? Alright, well, you're drawing cards, but you gotta cast them, too. Paradox Engine costs 5. Oh, alright, well, that was less eventful than the first game, let's say that. I'm just gonna submit like this, because I think we're in good shape. Collector Brutality doesn't even actually have a ton of hits. I guess he hits, like, Tezzeret's Gambit. But I think it's probably better than... Is it better than Nihil Spellbomb? I mean, Blood Moon locks them out of a lot of their colors, and it also shuts off Academy Ruins and Inventor's Fair, which they seem to need. I think we can submit like this. I think it's fine. Why do they have no ways to get rid of artifacts? This hand is pretty mediocre. We don't have a thing to do until, like, turn 3. Yeah, it's pretty rough. I don't like discarding with this deck because cards like Zombie Infestation and Call of Bloodline are pretty card intensive, so you have to discard things. But I think this is a better hand, so we'll keep it. As long as we got a call, we're good. I went to 5, so that's pretty good. Brutality... Yeah, we have Squee. I can't imagine not keeping a Collector Brutality on top. Like, if we get to hit from their hand, it's just great. Oh my god, I thought this was an Astral Cornucopia, and I was like, 6 counters? How did you even do that? That would probably be the most broken start in Modern, I think. I think we're just getting a... Nah, we're just gonna get a Swamp. We have Blood Moons in our deck. We don't want Blood Moon lock ourselves, so... If we had a, Oh, the old double Surge Node draw. That's interesting. Yeah, this is reasonable for us. I'm just going to crack this now. I don't think we care about a third land, so. Probably get one anyway, though. Just good times. We can't activate Call the Bloodline, so there's no reason not to collect a Brutality here. Yep. Choose an opponent. Well, there's only one, so I'm going to let you guess. Give me that Gambit. Natural State. Ooh. Ooh. I think we want to get the Natural State. Like, that's our... Yeah, let's get rid of the Natural State. That, like, that affects our engine. Vroom, vroom. Oh, they did nothing. You did nothing. All right, let's do it again. Always yes, always yield. Let's see what happens. All right, we did it. Pick up the telephone and call the Bloodline. Call the Bloodline now. So we're only going to be able to do one thing, so we can just wait till their turn to do it. Bobbers. They do have Tezzeret's Gambit, so one more land and they can put 2 counters on these, but this guy's not impressive when you don't have any actual, like, mana rocks. Oh, like, asked me if I want to do this, and I said always yes, but I don't know. I don't know why. I thought it was because there were 2 on the stack last time, but now I guess not. I guess it just... That's just the thing it does. Well, we're definitely discarding... If we discard Squee to cast Grave Scrabbler, we get back Squee, but we don't have anything to do with it, so we want 4 mana to do that. 1 to discard... No, I don't... It doesn't matter. We have to discard Squee here, because we're not going to play Grave Scrabbler. Because then we can't use it next turn, and I'd rather just use it this turn and next turn. Well, they do have artifacts, though, so Inventor's Fair is going to get a little... Also, these vampire knights could price them out of any sort of walking ballista shenanigans, but maybe not, because they just go infinite, right? So... Alright, well... We know there's a Tezzeret's Gambit in their hand. I always yes to triggered ability from Squee Goblin and a mob. Yes. I don't know how many, why? Why can't you just do it? Just do the thing I'm instructing you to do within your own program. That's all. That's all I'm asking for. I didn't think it was a lot. But what do I know? Apparently nothing. This card's just a straight up better Gravecrawler, right? Oh, it's only if the madness costs us pay that you get a dude back. And by Gravecrawler, I meant Gravedigger. So that's interesting. We can also just cast Squee. Ooh, is that better? Nope, it's not better. Just so you know. Alright, well, we're making a vampire army here. 2/1/1s a turn. That's the speed I like to win at in Modern. But that's not to say this deck isn't sweet. Like, if they had creatures, we can Voldaren Pariah and start wrecking face. Here we go. Something scary. That's not that scary. You can't even cast that. I mean, this is not them. You can't count them out yet either. Like, there's a couple good draws that they can hit and just knock us out of the B park, as they say. All right, I'm gonna have to hit yes twice, I imagine. Yep. All right. God, always yes. That's a heck of an ability. What if when we're programming Magic Online, we put a feature that says always yes? But it doesn't always yes. Sometimes it doesn't yes at all. What about other times? Well, other times it might yes. Okay, well, this is an interesting feature you're implementing here. But is there going to 10? Liliana might be... Actually, I think we just want to keep calling the bloodline. I think Liliana's probably going to be better when they, Well, I don't know. Like, we can make them sack their core tap, or they're just going to put counters on a Surge node, I guess, which is fine. Probably better than them playing, like, Astral Cornucopia and then putting counters on that. But we do get to draw a card here, which is nice. I love drawing cards. They did it a third land. All right, now we're going to get rid of this. This core tapper, and then it's going to be like a two-turn clock. Oh, they didn't let us draw. That's nice of them. I mean, that's a smart play because, like, they already played their land for the turn, I believe. Right? Where are we at? Oh, yeah, they played Yav My Coast. Okay. Just making sure. Still yes. Just in case you forgot Magic Online. Well, that's pretty good. Well, now you have to put your counters on a Surge node. Joke's on you. You sacrificed anyway. Yeah. Everybody in. All 7/1. Oh, you're giving me a card during my turn? Alright, well. I'm not one to look a gift card in the mouth. They don't have mouths, that's usually why. Go to 37. Feels good. Go to 35. Feels bad. We can play Cryptbreaker or we can discard a Squee. Probably just discarding a Squee.
Like, these aren't zombies, so we're not going to be able to draw a card from the Crypt Breaker. And I do, like, the lifelink from the vampires, so. All right. Another call to Bloodline. I think you're dead. Have a good feeling about it. Maybe. Oh, doing a thing. Tezzeret's Gambit. Like, what can you draw to save you here? Like, green mana fog? Until next turn? You got 7 cards in hand. Okay, well, that's the end. Alright, we'll see you guys in round 3. Well, I think we're going to keep this hand. We got a turn 1, a sniper, turn 2, zombie infestation. Ideally, we'll be able to get some things like Grave Scrabblers, Big Game Hunters, Lingering Souls, and Squeeze to discard profitably. Let's find out. Concealed Courtyard. Oh, there's a Voldaren Pariah. Here's a Ruthless Sniper. Oh, that's a weird feeling to be playing in Modern, let me tell you. It's really good, though. Like, discarding 2 cards of Zombie Infestation and then paying 2 just lets you kill anything. Oh, looks like we got some Eldrazi's. Thalia. Well, that is unfortunate. That's super awkward. All right, you got it. This is where they go, Leon and Arbiter, Ghost Quarter, kill our land. We feel stupid for playing Blood Crypt here, but I guess let's hope not. Oh, maybe nothing here. No blocks, as you can imagine. Nope, there is a land. Eldrazi Displacer. Thought Not Seer. Yep, that's pretty good. That's pretty good. Wow. Sometimes it's interesting to just look at the sequence of events that had to happen in order for us to be knocked off the strategy. So it's like we had to be on the draw, or else we could have just played this on turn 2. They had to have Thalia, which prevented us from playing it on turn 2. And then they had to have Thought Not Seer and Eldrazi Temple on turn 3 to rip it out of our hand. If any one of those didn't happen, I think we're actually fine. And now we draw land. Yeah, that's, I don't know, that's super weird to me. Like, it's just interesting when things line up like that. Because now we have nothing. Like, actual nothing. That's so sad. Yeah. I mean, if we had a way to kill this Thought Knots here, that'd be great, but alas. If we can draw another Zombie Infestation here, it'd be fantastic. All right. Not looking great for us, boys. I mean, I don't really care what you take here because neither of these are actually going to have much use for us. Zombie Infestation one time. Bloodstained Mire. Sure. So now we take 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We go to 4. And I'm not sure there's any sequence of events that are actually going to let us come back from this. This is how we died. Not with a bang, but with an Eldrazi. Pretty sure that's how the saying goes.
Well, we don't have to block here. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we won't. Because this guy still does some work by killing Athalia. Flicker Wisp. Sure. Yep. Well, we do get to draw a card, which is nice. It's going to be a zombie infestation, though. Oh, it's just land. How nice. I mean, now you just get my last Grave Scrabbler. So, well, it's not my last Grave Scrabbler. It's actually my first Grave Scrabbler. But you're getting the last card in my hand, which is a Grave Scrabbler. So, you know. Yeah, it's a lot of lands. Thank you. Thank you for your solid commentary from well, you know, that's what happens when you rip the cards out of my hand, I guess. That's life though. We're not gonna Dark Blast and Fatal Push both seem very good in this matchup. I don't hate Big Game Hunter either. I could take out one Grave Scrabbler. Probably one. I'm not thrilled about Despair. Yeah, we can take that out. I think this is fine. Maybe Dark Blast is worth it just to kill things like Thalia. But Fatal Push also does that, and it also kills Thought Knots here, so. Eh, we'll see. Alright, I will play first. I don't hate this hand. It doesn't have, doesn't really have our engine, but it has half of our engine with, like, both of these. Actually, Crypt Breaker is a perfectly reasonable way to discard things, so. I'm gonna run a Crypt Breaker out there first. Discard Lingering Souls on turn 2. Discard something else on turn 3 and Ruthless Sniper. And also, Liliana with Ruthless Sniper is also not bad, so. Either Vial, sure. Yeah, we're just making a zombie here. I have yet to actually cast Lingering Souls, so I've yet to make any spirits from the graveyard. Well, that's sad. I think that's sad. I don't even know. They might not name. What if they don't name Crypt Breaker? They could name Liliana, right? And they did name Crypt Breaker. Fuldaren Pariah. Alright, well, next turn we can actually play Sniper. Well, if we need more land, we can go Sniper, discard, and make and put a counter on a thing, so. I don't know. I'm intrigued to see how this match plays out. Like, last game we drew a million lands, this game we've drawn two, so. That's Magic to get the ring for you. Okay, well, that's an interesting choice. I think the only thing you saw, you didn't even see anything first game, so I don't know why you'd bring that in. That's weird. Unless you're just assuming I have Squeeze in the deck. Yep. Always a pleasure, Death and Taxes deck. Always a pleasure. Sorry, guys. A little frustrating. Just not even being able to do anything here. The old Pithy Needle, rest in peace, Leon and Arbiter draw. A classic. What did we show them that they would bring in rest in peace for? They didn't see Squee. I don't think they saw Lingering Souls. Sure. Is this deck well represented enough to be like like they're onto us? I don't understand. Oh well, I mean, it's fine, whatever. Yep, Liliana. That's a good one. Not like I'll be casting that anytime soon. Huh. There's double block here? And then they Flicker Wisp in and kill one of my guys? Yeah, let's avoid that. Flicker Wisp Crypt Breaker. Yeah, this is fun. I'm having a good time. So we have no profitable attacks. Well, might as well set ourselves up to try to do something at some point. Let's see if they put it to four. Yep. All right. So pretty sure they have a Flicker Wisp in hand. Sure. Block this guy. And yeah, obviously. Sure. Seems fine. Still got the block, whatever. yeah, so. Can I get one land? That's fine. We're not in terrible shape, I guess. All right, now we're getting somewhere. We've never cast this, so it's actually just a blank here. Got my arrows. Could have done this during their turn. I don't know if that's better though. Doesn't matter. Like, we could have blocked and then shot, but I don't really want to take seven, so. I can see double blocking here. I have one card in hand. Yeah, if they attack, we're just taking six. Oh, you have something. Oh, path. Sure. Oh, look, I searched and got nothing. how fun. Alright, well, they have no cards in hand, so maybe this Call the Bloodline does some work. Or we can just chump block here. Nah, we can just take six and go to eight. They have one card. Guess it's a good one. Just another Thought Knots here. The top decks are real. And now we're just going to hit a land. Oh, Crypt Breaker. Oh, that's nice. We hit the one card that they have. This is like just the worst luck ever, right? I don't feel like we're actually doing... Oh, it's so, oh man, rude, just the rudest. It always amazes me that these decks go like 5-1 or 6-0 or 5-0, you know, whatever the record is, because it's just like, if they stumble at all, it's just so brutal. This is at least a guy. I think we just discard the Blood Moon. That is one ruthless sniper. And we're just going to chump block a Thought Not Seer here, because otherwise we die. So we got a 5. Sure. Seems fine. Can they hit a land? Maybe. Ugh, I don't want to play that because, like, we're just drawing, like, all these cards. Like, if it was one land, we can actually play Cryptbreaker, discard. Nah, we wouldn't have anything to discard, but we could discard Cryptbreaker and still have a land for next turn. Like, I don't know. It's something. Like, as it stands now, we're never blocking with these guys. Yeah, let's just hope you don't have a 3-drop or a 2-drop in hand that just wrecks us, but most of your guys die to Ruthless Sniper, so. So yeah, we're going to just be breaking Crypts now. And by breaking Crypts, I mean discarding Crypt Breaker to Ruthless Sniper, to Call the Bloodline, and triggering Ruthless Sniper. I mean, eventually we'll get to a point where we can just kill these guys with counters, I hope. Choose you. Make a bloodline guy. I think that guy's just better than Cryptbreaker here, right? So we might as well just block with the Cryptbreaker. Go to 3? Ugh, not ideal, but... Alright, land for them. Seems good. Zombie Infestation. Does that do anything for us here? No. It's almost worth just discarding. All right, let's get in there for 2. Oh, boy. Boy, oh, boy. Huh? Yeah, just going to discard. Seems fine. Living off 2 lands here, which is pretty comical. I feel like it's only a matter of time before they draw something that's just so far and away better than what we have right now. Like an Eldrazi Displacer or something. But... And again, like a black-red deck, so we have no answers for things like Rest in Peace or Pithing Needle. Pithing Needle we could kill because we're playing red, so we can have something like Kolaghan's Command. But enchantments like Rest in Peace are just pretty bad. Yep, make another dude. Discard Infestation. I think Sniper's just better on this board. Shrink this dude. Double block. We can also take 2, go to 3. Just take 2, gain 1. Which seems... Is that better than going to 1 and then killing this guy? I think we just kill this guy. I mean, they have to get rid of both of these guys. Yep, they have something. Path. That's actually okay. We wanted that land anyway. Alright. Go to 1. Okay, that's actually pretty good. All right. I think we're on to something here. Can't actually attack. Can't believe we're actually in this game. It's kind of comical. Pretty sure we're just double blocking here. Block, block. Actually, we have a Ruthless Sniper to block, though. The Thought-Outs here is going to be a 1-1, which is just great. And next turn, we can put two counters on something else. Ghost Quarter is fine. You don't have an Arbiter in play. Are we coming back at 1? This is pretty ridiculous. I'm coming back in this game with Ruthless Sniper and Call the Bloodline in Modern. I don't know how to explain it. It's a strange phenomenon. Oh, keeping that guy at home, huh? All right. A bold strategy, Cotton. Oh, Squee never comes back, actually, so never mind. That's real sad. I forgot about Rest in Peace. I got so excited. Like, we're going to block this guy anyway. I might as well try to kill this guy, right? Yeah, that was bad. Well, not bad, but... not great. Man, Squee every turn would have been so exciting. I mean, I guess we're just going to be discarding every card we draw anyway, so... but now we can discard a dude, make a guy, and put two counters on this. So that's pretty reasonable. Yeah, alright. Well, we'll see, I guess. This is where they flash in Flicker Wisp. No, I guess not. It never dies either, so we don't actually get to draw a card. Wait. Oh, yeah, we do. Yeah, we do. Okay. Oh, that's pretty good. I'm going to assume you can't draw two answers to these guys. We're just going to come in for... yeah, you'd have to have two answers, which is just not a reasonable thing to have. So, two dudes it is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Actually, the funny thing is you can actually flash in Eldrazi Displacer with Aether Vial and then blink both of my tokens. I guess that kills us. That ain't it. Oh, the attacks have ceased. Do we play this land? Actually, well, let's just play Liliana and make them sacrifice. How about that? And if we draw land, we can still make a... yeah, mine was too. Ironically, this was a two-lander. Yeah, mine was too. Alright, let's try again, I guess. Collector Brutality kills, like, all of their things. So I think I'm gonna take those out, take the Lingering Souls out for Collector Brutality, especially because they have Rest in Peace. Like, even if we're just trading with Thalia or Leon an Arbiter or something, it's still good. So, I think that's actually fine. I don't really want Dark Blast. It kills certain things, but it doesn't kill enough. So, we'll see. Alright. Game 3. We're going to keep this hand. We're not on the play, which is unfortunate because it leads to some Tide Hollow Sculler slash Thalia blowouts. But... We'll see. We're also going to keep cracking these early because I don't really feel like dealing with Leon and Arbiter, so... Yeah, figured you'd take a point here. Yep. Crack immediately. And now we can actually collective brutality this guy. I don't feel like dealing with this nonsense. Collective brutality and look at their hand. Steal a path, perhaps? Seems good. Kill a dude. Reveal hand. This seems good. Zealous Persecution, and your hand is Temple, Shambling Vent, Caves, Dark Confidant. Oh, that's good. Next turn you Confidant, and we kill it. Oof. And we get a Lily on board. Everything's coming up Millhouse, so Shambling Vent down, which means you do get to attack with Dark Confidant. But I'm definitely not letting you draw lands here. Or extra cards, rather. I just don't feel like having any Bloodstained Mires in my deck anymore. Or in my hand, rather, when they have things like Leon and Arbiter. Also, this is your turn, so we can actually go call, discard, Squee. Yeah, so your hand is Temple, Caves, and something else. So that's pretty unimpressive. I mean, if you play Thought Knots here, that's rough, but... But I like our start here, so that's pretty cool. Yep, figured this would happen. Something good. So we can call, we can discard Pariah and Squee to make two dudes. And then Pariah, we just get back next turn. With Gravescrabbler. Seems pretty good. Why would you do this? I thought we was friends. I'm gonna see what they take. If they take Gravescrabbler, we can just keep Pariah in hand. And if they take Pariah, well. Actually, maybe we should have discarded Pariah so they can't take it, but. Yep. So, did you play Caves? Yeah, you didn't play Temple yet. So we need to have Eldrazi, Temple, and one other card. Always yes, always yield. That time you did it. I don't understand. Alright, so we're just going to amass a million dudes here, which is kind of nice. Two dudes a turn. That's pretty good. Alright, well... Seems like they're getting the land flood now, so... I mean, this would be a terrifying situation to have them hit a rest in peace because we have so many Squees, but we have no cards that can actually get scrambled. This one Tidehollow Sculler is really wrecking our day. Can we get one Ruthless Sniper here? That would be a gas. Do we actually attack here? I don't even know. Oh my god, it's so hard to unclick all of them. I think we're fine passing here. I mean, I guess we can get Squee back with Gravescrabbler. Yeah, probably should have discarded Pariah, but... Here comes a Thought Knots here. Flicker Wisp. Okay. Flicking Call of the Bloodline. Make a dude. Interesting. Rest in peace in response to Gyarados Squeeze. Probably. Wasteland Strangler. Okay. Well, now you get to put my call in the graveyard, which is unfortunate. Yeah, that's pretty bad. Yep. That was our engine. We have four crypt breakers. Three more calls. Oh, bring your card. That was a good use of things, though. Yes. And yes. Infestation. That's actually pretty good, I guess. So make them sacrifice. If they sacrifice, they'll probably sacrifice one of these two, right? They don't have any cards to discard. Eh. Yeah, it is what it is. Like, we're not going to be discarding Grave Scrabblers or Squeeze in current situations, so. If we had a creature in the graveyard, we can discard Grave Scrabbler, but Liliana would go to. We wouldn't have enough mana to play Liliana and discard Grave Scrabbler at the same time. Things are running out of control here. Liliana dies, you take a Squee, I presume, because it's just very, very good. They have no cards in hand, though. Like, they're still in top deck mode. But when you're top decking Wasteland Strangler, Flicker Wisp, and Thought Knot Seer, it's pretty good. Yeah. All right. So long, Liliana. God, Flicker Wisp killing, like, well, I guess Shambling Vent killed the first Liliana, but. Frustrating. I mean, we have 5/1/1 lifelinkers, so. Game's not over. This is where they draw Eldrazi Displacer. And we're like, well, that'll do. Burr, burr, burr. I feel like not discarding Pariah was probably our mistake here, but I don't know. I guess we could have actually played Squee. Playing Squee is probably the choice, right? Yeah, it's fine. Lose two zombies. Vampires. Whatever they are. Yeah, we probably should have played Squee, because then we can chump block here. But then the problem is if they don't attack with anything, Squee doesn't do anything, right? Like, we'd rather just not have him on board to die. Yeah, that's pretty good. That's. First time we got to play Big Game Hunter Kills a Thought Knot Seer. That is gas. We draw a card. It is another Call to Bloodline. Wow. Things just got real. Now we can chump with Big Game Hunter, get it back with Grave Scrabblers. Oof. That was big game, you might say. That was gas. Now we're getting some lucky draws. Alright, so. Feels okay. Uh-oh. Thought Knot Seer number two, taking our other Squee. No, Flicker Wisp. Hitting other Flicker Wisp. Okay. Hitting. Probably call, so that we can't use it on our turn. Sure, that's fine. Oh, boy! Getting real excited. That was a great draw, too. Holy smokes.
Yeah, this is nice. Feeling good. All right. Well, I think we just took over. They're at 21, so like anything can happen, but they don't really have inevitability in their deck. Like, they just play creatures, right? Like, Lenient Arbiter doesn't do much against us now because we have five lands. We have kind of an engine going with Squee. That's unfortunate. Attempted to kill this guy too. Get rid of a Grave Scrabbler. Actually, I'm tempted to call the Bloodline and then kill our own Ruthless Sniper so we can get it back with Scrabbler, which I think is probably best, but we have to discard a Scrabbler to do it. But I actually think it's fine. Discard a card. We'll discard Grave Scrabbler. We still make a guy, too. Oh, actually, it shoots itself. It's a 1-2, so that's not going to work, but we'll just kill the Flicker Wisps instead. Because we can use Grave Scrabbler to get back Grave Scrabbler and just chain Scrabblers. No. No cast. Maybe we should have killed Tidehollow Sculler to just... And by kill, I mean put it to 1-1 so that it can't actually block profitably. That might have been better, because I don't know if we're in any danger of dying to a Flicker Wisp with 5-1-1s. Yeah, we're going to land. 5-1-1s with lifelink specifically. If there were any 5-1-1s, that's not really impressive. We're just going to top deck out Ruthless Sniper, though, so it doesn't matter. That's not it. So, get rid of this guy. Okay. I think we're probably attacking this turn. They have no cards in hand? Yeah, this is pretty good. Wait, what? Hold on. We return target creature card from graveyard to its owner's hand. Okay, I was like, wait, why can I target your guys? Yeah, that's pretty niche. Here you go, have your Flicker Wisp back. If that's not a still had all these moment, I don't know what is. Yeah, we're just definitely attacking here. Go ahead, kill my big game hunter, I dare you. Alright, now we're getting somewhere. Do I want to play this swamp? I don't think so. Like, there's just no benefit to it, I feel like. Six lands is way more than enough for us to operate on. Vampires for days, my friends. We make two every cycle, and they can only kill one, so we're still netting guys. Oh, jeez. Mono Scrabblers dot deck. Yeah, this is pretty good. And none of our creatures are actually, like, super valuable. So... it's never, I never feel bad about just throwing them all in the red zone. This is extremely obnoxious, unfortunately. Yep, that's how we're gonna lose this one. By them exiling two dudes a turn. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, that's pretty bad. That's pretty bad. Sure. And then they eat one. They eat two. So they take 1, 2, 3, 4, they take 5. There's a Ruthless Sniper when you need it. Oh yeah, they had Path to Exile. Oh my god, Ruthless Sniper would be insane here. Kill both of these guys. And we can get back to the Grave Scrabbler, which is actually pretty nice. Yeah, we'll do that. That seems fine. Just cycle Grave Scrabblers forever. So that resolves. Yeah, they're going to have to take one. Like, because if we play one to get one back, they're just going to take the one we get back, so it doesn't really do anything. They only have 5 mana, though, so they can't... They can only exile one thing. That's pretty good. We have 6 minutes, they have 7, so... Gonna have to win this game pretty quick. There's a lot of clicking going on here, which is the big problem. Okay. Get back, Grave Scrabbler. I can see them blinking their own Tidehollow Sculler in order to take Squee during our upkeep, and then we just discard it, so that doesn't do anything, I guess. That's a spicy meatball. That is insanely epic. We could have actually waited till post-combat to play that, but I don't think it matters. Yep. So, we're at a point where if they don't do anything... I mean, we can actually, yeah, this is rough for them because we can discard 2 things easily, these 2. Yep, seems good. And they can't really blink anything here. So they're going to blink this. Which one do we want? We have the Pariah back, right? So we're going to kill this guy. They're going to blink it in response, and then we're just going to kill it again. So, oh, we can't. We can only... Oh. They just let this happen. Oh. Oh, that's pretty good. Because we can only call the Bloodline once a turn. Maybe they didn't know that, because we even forgot that, and we've been playing it for 3 rounds, so... You're going to exile that dude. Okay. All right. Well, we're getting somewhere. No cards in hand for them. And we have a Grave Scrabbler, so... This has been a back and forth game, man. Oh, yes. That is a great draw. 1, 2, 3. Not for them, of course. But, you know, for us. Good game. Good luck next round. You too. All right. We'll see you guys in round 4. All right. We're going to round 4 with our Mardu black, red, black, mostly crazy. I'm going to keep this hand. Call the Bloodline into Big Game Hunter could be a thing. Eh, I don't know. If we draw a Squee, we got some squeeze going on. My main squeeze. Oh boy, good times, good times. Flooded Strand, crack it. You can play Serum Visions right now. Don't even pretend like you're not playing a Serum Vision on turn 1. Anybody got time for these shenanigans? There you go. There you go. Don't even pretend. Thoughtseize. There is no Thoughtseize in the main deck. What a dummy. Actually, there might be. I think there's 2 in the main deck. Right? Right? There are not. There are none in the main deck. All 4 in the sideboard. I lied to you. And for that... I'm sorry. This is where they crack... They play Shadow of Doubt in response. I wonder how many times you can get people with just a Shadow of Doubt in Modern. Just playing 4 Shadow of Doubt in the main deck. People wait to crack their fetches, and you're just like, nah, you don't get a land right now. Sorry, brah. Remand, I'm fine with. Spell Snare, I'm not fine with. Spell Pierce, I'm also not fine with, so... Just let this... It's a call to the blood. Call the Bloodline, man. Just let it resolve. It's not even a threat to you. Mana Leak, I'm also not okay with. None of these. This is not resolving. Okay, cool. That was a good time. I'm having a good time. You guys having a good time at home? The problem is, if you don't have one of these cards, your deck's pretty rough. What we got? Like a Grave Scrabbler that doesn't trigger. Big Game Hunters that are probably pretty blank against this deck. A Voldaren Pariah that you don't really want to cast as a 3-3 for 5 mana. So, without any of your engines, it's rough. And unfortunately, Spell Snare is going to counter both Call and Zombie Infestation at any point on the curve. So, like, it's not a situation where we can be like, well, if you just wait, we can play around it. No, you can't really. I mean, I guess we can wait till we have two in hand, but good lord, how long does that take? That'll be like a year. Look, the point is, ain't nobody got time for that, really. Well, that's reasonable. Discard Big Game Hunter and just play it. It's actually not terrible. Gives us another body on the board. I mean, that's presuming they're not going to Cryptic Command this, which they are, so it doesn't really matter. But, you know, if this resolved, then we could do that. But as you can see, the old spell, Serum Visions into spell, like, we've literally predicted all three of their plays this game.
But Frank, they've played 4 spells. They also played a second Serum Visions that you didn't mention.
I guess that's true. I guess they did do that. Did I just run out of Grave Scrabbler? That seems terrible. Like, we're not going to win this. They're going to play Dragonlord Ojutai next turn, and then we're just going to be like, well, that's rough. But we also don't win this by not casting Grave Scrabbler here. So, I don't know, man. Oh my god, I'm hard casting a Grave Scrabbler in Modern. This is my life. This is what it's come down to, ladies and gentlemen. Are you Cryptic Command this dude too? It's a Grave Scrabbler. Grave Scrabbly McScrabblerson. Wow. Ojutai's command. Jeez. Alright, well, we're just going to have 6 here because, seriously. Wow, you didn't do anything. You missed, like, 2 land drops? Come on, buddy. Well, we're going to attack first in case you're in the mood to counter this, I guess. Or to bounce and draw a card with Cryptic Command, I guess. You drew 2 cards. You draw an extra card off Cryptic Command and off Ojutai's Command. You Serum Vision twice and you can't hit a 5th land? I'm real intrigued, man. These are some weird situations, my friend. Yep. It's okay. Nothing resolves. Nothing resolves against JB Spec 3. Yeah, you got it. We're having a good time. 16 turns, they die to Ruthless Sniper, so we got that going for us. I guess we can just F6 here. Oh, they didn't do anything again. But they did get a Colonnade, which is nice. You know, for them, not for us. It's going to be a Squee. Ready? Oh, it's a land. Oh, that's great. Grave Scrabbler. Big Game Hunter's pretty good against Colonnade if we can engineer a situation where they activate it during our turn. I don't know if that's going to happen, though. Let's cast Voldaren Pariah for 5 mana. Huh? Wow, it resolved. Well, I'll path to exile it. Boop. Nothing. It just survives. I'm intrigued. Okay, well, we had a good run. 1-1 and 3-3. I guess, can we draw something good here? No. No, we cannot. Well, I think we're dead. They have six cards. I don't feel good about this match at all. I don't feel good about this match at all. I don't even know if we play Squee here. I don't think there's a purpose to it. Do it anyway. Do it anyway. Guess we can have six here. I mean, if they make us discard, we can discard Gravescrabbler, pay the madness cost, and get back Pariah. Wow. That's insane. It was just a 1-1 on the board. Alright, well. I guess Squee is that terrifying. Okay, well. I don't even know what to say. Like, it's just mono lands and madness creatures that don't do anything on their own. Like, this Call of the Bloodline was this countered Call of the Bloodline was pretty timely. We can't beat them when they have this much mana. They're just going to Sphinx's Revelation at some point. Yep, this is rough. I think we're just dead. I mean, we could always cast one of these guys, but they just block. We don't have... Yep. This is Sphinx of Revelation, and... Game two. Seems good. Not going to let you draw five, gain five. Blood Moon. Collective Brutality. Thought Seize. Dark Blast can come out. Snipers can come out. Probably too. Actually, Big Game Hunter is probably great against Colonnade. It's probably better than Sniper, right? Three more cards, huh? Actually, I kind of like casting Despair, but like if it's stuck in our hand, we just have nothing to do with it, which is kind of sad. Bring in Lingering Souls. Keep two Big Game Hunters, I guess. Fatal Push also kills Colonnade. Which I don't know if that's great. Two cuts. I think we just take out one more Big Game Hunter and probably like one Gravescrabbler. I guess that's fine. All right. Well, let's see what happens. Mulligan. Sure, I guess. Ugh. Don't have a third land. Can't really keep Liliana, unfortunately. I mean, if we draw Call or Zombie Infestation, we want to be able to actually... Wow, double Supreme Verdict. I want to take this Spell Snare, because this is a terrible hand. I have no idea why you kept the 2-land. 4-mana. Hand, but maybe it'll work out for you. Zombie Infestation. Get rewarded. I mean, I don't know what we'd be being rewarded for. We actually, pretty sure we had to ship first hand, and yep, that's not going to do it. Alright, so those are the two lands we know about. Bloodstained Mire. I think we're just playing a Squee here. If they kill it, eh. Oh, you hit a land. Lose two life. Sure. Don't counter this. Yep. All right. Sure. Nice draw. So two of the three cards you had to hit would be land and negate. That's pretty good. Hey, that's pretty good. So we get a squee back if we draw. They didn't hit a land. All right. So always yes, always yield. Grab this dude. Zombie Infestation. Grave Scrabbler with no discard outlet. I feel like one Overgrown Tomb could be reasonable just so you can actually play this. Like, why would you not... Sure. Like, why would you not have this... in your... Like, what... Wait, what? Interesting. Are you gonna rest in peace? Oh, you got rid of your own Dragon Lord Ojutai. Okay, sure. Well, we now live in Cryptic Command / Ojutai's Command territory. I don't know why you even got rid of this guy. That was a weird choice, but... Just gonna play him again. Alright. This has been extremely interesting. But, like, this deck, unless you can start... Have a good... Like, I wasn't gonna go to... Wow. Targeting yourself. Getting rid of a Supreme Verdict. Alright, so now we know you have Ojutai, Supreme, Cryptic Command, two other cards in hand. Get a load of this guy. Yep, so they can just counter pretty much everything we play. This counter is a creature, right? Yeah, that's good. Yep, I think we're just dead here. Like, the Ojutai's Command counter this draw card. They counter the next thing with Cryptic Command. We're also at 12. I'm just going to skip here. We can't win this game. They just have inevitability. They're just going to draw million cards, and if we ever get out of hand, they have a Supreme Verdict. So we'll see you guys in the last round. All right, round three. We're going to play first, because that's how we do. This hand seems good. We will keep it. We're going to go Ruthless Sniper into Blood Call of Lines, and then we're going to just drop this dude like it's hot. Like the dankest of memes. Get busy sniping. You gonna lightning bolt this dude? No. Wow, play a bird and we got a Ruthless Sniper in the board? Oof. A bold move, Cotton. A bold strategy, Cotton. Let's see if it pays off. All right, well, Devoted Druid's a little scary, but we can actually kill the Devoted... No, we can't. Not yet. This takes two mana. So, I'm going to Bloodstain Mire here and get a basic, because I don't feel like drawing a sixth land, and this will decrease the odds ever so slightly. May the odds be decreased ever so slightly in your favor. We could also put a counter on this. Actually, bird is their only white source right now, so we're going to go with that. Yeah. And also, next turn, we can discard Despair, activate Despair. All the guys get Menace, and that's pretty good. Discard three cards? Ooh. All right, Ruthless Sniper, killing birds. Well, that's... It's pretty graphic, I guess, but we are going to discard Despair. Target you, can't use it, but it is what it is, boss. All right. Yeah, of course I'll get this squee back. That's a great idea, Magic Online. play Swamprums. Discard. Squee. Shoot you. And they're dead. All right, sweet. We were just going to cast this and make them discard three of the five cards in their hand. Seems good. Do we want Blood Moon in this deck? We definitely want Collective Brutality, that's for sure. That's for true. Don't think Big Game Hunter is very good in this matchup. That's my assumption. Thoughtseize could be good. Yeah, we're going to bring in two Thoughtseizes. Everything else seems fine. I like the rest of the deck. This deck has creatures in it, so that's pretty good for us. Hey, that's pretty good. This hand is good. Cliffs into Thoughtseize. Bird again? Noble Hierarch. Ruthless Sniper? No? Okay. Let's take a gander at that sweet, sweet hander. So they have Collected Company and Court of Calling? Ooh, gross. This is actually where we don't care about Kasali Pride Mage. They just play Vizier next turn. If they draw land, they go Collected Company. Let's get rid of Vizier. Because that's one they can cast, and it's also they have to find one of the other two pieces with these guys, right? So like if we let them keep Vizier, they can just cord for Devoted Druid. If we let them keep Vizier, they have to hit off Collected Company. But now they have to hit both off of both cards, which is not as easy, I guess. Pride Mage. Did you just attack with Noble Hierarch pre-combat and then play Kasali Pride Mage post-combat? No, Devoted Druid. Okay, well, that's cool. Well, that's pretty cool. We can't actually do anything this turn. Ooh, gross. Play Blood Crypt here. Next turn we can play Cliffs. Can you win this turn? If you hit a land, you could win this turn. No, actually, you can win this turn anyway. Well, not win. Interesting. You could have actually untapped this, played Cord for 5, and then just made infinite mana, right? Maybe you want to keep Cord up? Knight, Eternal Witness. Sure. Well, pretty sure we're too far behind here, but... Sniper is pretty good here. But we don't have any way to discard things, so it's not as good here. Jeez. Like Liliana, do we just discard something? We know their hand is Pride Mage, Cord, Collected Company. No, we know their hand is Cord and Pride Mage. Gross. Like, they just get rid of Noble Hierarch? I think we're dead here, but we're going to make them do it, I guess. What's happening? Oh, they just naturally drew it. Okay. It's pretty good. So what do you cord for? I don't know. I mean, you can't cord for Walking Ballista because it goes into play. So we have Pride Mage and Cord in hand. No, you discarded Pride Mage. So we now have Cord and one other card in hand, sure. Duskwatch Recruiter. That's good. Now you can just activate this guy infinitely. Okay, that's the combo then. They get Recruiter, and then they just keep searching until they find a Walking Ballista. Yeah, that's fine. All I need to see. So, Dark Blast should definitely come in then, because now I feel silly for not bringing these in the first place. Take out one Liliana, I'll take out one Grave Scrabbler. Submit like that. I will play first. This hand seems great. Ruthless Sniper into Zombie Infestation and with Dark Blast. Yeah, I feel good about this hand. So I'm gonna have an optimistic outlook here. And we'll see if that's a good enough. I like the Zombie Infestation. We discard like two cards and then shoot two things. Oh yeah, do we just kill that? It's real tempting to just kill that right now. Because next turn we can still play Infestation and discard these two. And, yeah, kill that thing as well. Nope, just draw a card naturally. This one? There you go. You might say this is pretty ruthless. Yep. I don't think I'm going to activate that second trigger, but you never know. Ooh, they kept a one lander and 2/0/1 creatures. Seems good. I mean, for us, not for them, of course. Good games. Oh, that's rough. Rough. Apparently, you just can't beat the Ruthless Sniper into Zombie Infestation. Thank you guys so much for watching. Be sure to hit the subscribe or the like button down below if you guys enjoy the content, and I'll see you guys next time.